again. This is the second installment of the Little Mix DNA. I'm sorry I was doing that. I was actually trying to show you that I got. I did Jessie's hair. I mean, it was an epic fail, but I did her little poof thing. Okay. Anyway, bright light. Okay, I'm Kremlin. This is the... I said Jessie, didn't I? I meant Leanne, I'm sorry. But this is the Leanne look. It was pretty easy. It's the red lips like I showed on Perry. I explain it again because I show a different way of doing it. My teeth look really white. And it's a simple cat eye. That is pretty much hers. Oh, and a lot of highlight. So, yeah, this is Leanne, and let's get into it. Starting off with a cream base. Like always, I am using, again, my Revlon palette. I like to use cream bases before I start my eyeshadows because then it helps keep the makeup in place all day and I don't have to worry about creasing. Using a white matte, cover the whole eyelid. Taking a medium near skin tone brown like this one. Going to swish around a little and moving that along the crease. Basically you can kind of like you're blending a cup crease in a smoky eye. Bring the light skin tone color. Next is the cat liner that she is wearing in the video. The way to get this cat liner is very easy. The way I did on this side is you line up your liquid liner. I'm using a felt tip for this stuff and then going into a normal liquid. You line up with your nose, hit the point where you're going to want to go, and then go down. Line up with nose. I want it to start like a little outside the crease. So. And then you connect. Sorry, my hands in the way. Basically connect, create a cat eye outline. Like so. And then taking your normal liquid eyeliner, I'm using Almé, not Avon. I think I named this Avon in my last video. I'm sorry. All my liquid liner in black. Take this and fill it in. I am still working on my lighting situation here, as you can tell. And she had on pretty thick. It took me a few times watching it to realize that all she had on was the cat liner. So make it kind of a thick line. Next is, it looks like she has it, plus it's a step that I always do whenever I'm wearing makeup. I'm sorry, I'm having my eyelashes here. Whenever I'm wearing makeup is I line my tight line and my waterline. I sharpened it today, so it should. Work better than my last video, where I had the whole eye issue. And that is your cat liner. For Leanne. Now I'm sorry I hit that. That was actually really loud. Anyway, I darkened my eyebrows and then just filled them in following my normal arch. So, again, I use this palette. This is my favorite palette, as you can tell. I use it all the time. But for this look, because her eyebrows are much darker than mine, I use the darkest shade in here, along with my trusty eyeliner pencil, pen, brush, thingy-majigger. I always start at the bottom. I don't even know why, it just became habit that I will start at the bottom whenever I do eyebrows. Then I also just filled it in because mine are thick in the middle and then on the outsides. So I filled that in. Then you take your little eyebrow brush and brush it out like last time. The good thing about all the little mixes video tutorials for their DNA video is they keep their makeups similar, but at the same time there's something unique about each of them. Anyway, that's it for the eyes. I can't go too close. The thing freaks out. Okay, here we go. And that's, after the camera focuses, that's your eye. If you can't tell, I'm having issues today with my camera and my lighting. So, I'm having issues, basically. And, alright, let's keep going before I rant. When I was trying to get Leanne's, basically my interpretation was not too much contouring, but a lot of highlight. And normally for highlight, all I do is I use a lighter powder foundation with a brush. It fell off my counter. That's why that has it. But this is the L'Oreal Paris True Match Natural Powder. And that's what I use for highlight. It's the lightest shade they make. And I use that for highlight. But if you don't want to do that, from Sephora for my birthday, I got the Benefit What's Up thing. So I'm actually going to do it on two different ways. This side will be my normal powder highlight, and this will be using a actual cheek highlighter. We'll see which one comes out better. My money's on the powder. But first, before we can get to the highlighting, got to contour. And it's just a light contour for Leanne. Basically, just do the, if you can do it the way I'm doing, which is without having to do the fish face, props to you if you need to do the fish face. And then you just fill in wherever the hollows were on your cheeks. For Leanne, because it's such a more natural one, I'm just kind of contouring the way I always do, because our faces are so different. My nose is too big to do her nose. I could sit here and slim my nose for hours and I won't reach Leanne's. Alright, on to the main part of hers, which was highlights. If you decide to do the powder trick like I do, what you do is you would open it. I'm not doing that right now because it's, I would end up with a white desk. But you would open it and you pour some of the powder from here into here. And then the brush is in this section and you just beat it. And then hopefully it doesn't open on you. You pop it off. Comes out like that. Like that. That's all the powder. Off a little. And I first just place it in a line where I will want the highlights. Okay, then we go back and we fill it in. First with this brush, and then because of how messy that brush is, you bring out your trusty powder brush and you fix whatever the powder just did. And that's how you do the powder trick. Now I'm going to use this highlighter, which I don't actually use often, so we get to see the comedy routine of this. Alright, you go wherever the highest point of your cheekbone is, which on me, you can find really easily. Highlight the points wanting to be highlighted. And I just need to highlight my nose a little. And let's see. It's like makeup everywhere. We can highlight our cupids though too, because if I remember correctly, hers is highlighted. Alright. And there you have it for the face. Comment below on which side is your favorite. Would you rather be powder? Or the what's up? Yeah, let me know below. Next we move on to the lips, which is the same as it was for Perry. All I have on right now is chapstick. But the same trick I used before, which was the lip liners, the lip liner duo. Now, as you saw in the first one, I started with the brown and I went to the red. This one I'm doing it the other way around because that's actually the way that Candy does it. And you can see the difference between the two, see which way you'd rather do it. And this is my final video where I'm going to be showing the lips because Jesse has the lips too, but I'm not going to just show them. I'm just going to do them and say, look at this video or the Perry one. That way I don't have to do this look. Like 10 times. This lip slipped into that, that's what I meant. Now the next step is using the brown, and we just line the lips with the brown. And also with this brown you can darken up the sides, and then I like to blend it a little bit down with my finger. Faces into a camera. It looks a little weird. As you see, I'm just blend it down. And then the final step, if you want, you take the red again and go over the round. Now, if you are watching this after watching my Perry video, you would notice in the first one I said that the reason I bought this Jordana lip liner, was because of the fact that it was with a blue undertone. And if you're wondering why I wanted blue undertone, I'm sorry, I'm trying to get my face. There we go. Is you see how white my teeth look now? It's because the blue undertone brings out the white in your teeth, but if you get one with an orange undertone, like I have one here because I accidentally bought the wrong shade the first time. This one, I bought it thinking it had blue undertone, and it's the Maybelline Red 50. And now, I don't know why, when I grabbed it, I thought it was a blue undertone. You take it on your finger. So that one comes out, and you see how this one is, so it's them next to each other. Still might not look too different, but if I blur it down, and if this camera goes into focus, it is a lot more orange when rubbed out than the Giordano one is, which has been rubbed out. But that wasn't enough. You can see a difference between them. The bottom is Giordano, the top is what's this? Maybelline. My camera's not helping much with this, I'm sorry. But so this is basically your completed look. I'll be back in a minute. So that is the finished look for Leanne of Little Mix. I did the hair like she has in the video, the high ponytail, smooth sides, and a poof. The poof took me a really long time. I don't know why I'm special. So yeah, comment below if you want need to do the hairstyle for you to show you how you can get this. I have really thick, ultra straight hair, so the poof, that's why it took me a really long time. Anyway, also if you have any requests, you can send me requests on YouTube, Tumblr, or Twitter. I have all the links in the description box below, along with all the products if I did not say it in the video. And that's it. Ooh, and subscribe. Bye.